Alright guys, welcome back. Oh man. So many bones. Starts talking, I'm just gonna let it play out because I do want to hear her thoughts, and I just keep doing whatever I'm doing and then exit out.
Gilded figures, servants of the Sun Queen. Sacrifice, murder. There's no record of these kinds of rituals in ancient Yamatai. Unless it was erased from the texts.
You know, Lara and Tombs are never a good match, because whenever a Tomb's near, that means one thing, something evil. Now I gotta figure out how to get up there.
Built in honor of our priestesses. Incredible.
So much treasure. One smart cookie. Yeah. Oh, okay. So, nothing's gonna attack me?
I can't do that now.
Okay, I was trying to figure out what to do, and so I jumped over there. Let's see what happens if I just climb up all the way. Arrows.
Expressly forbidden to leave the palace, but this did not stop me. My duties here are clear. I must learn the truth, but the stories I uncovered defy belief. Rumors abound of the queen's communion with the spiritual world. They say she commands the sun and the rain, that her lands are abundant by her will alone. This is certainly nonsense. But what can be the cause of such whispers? Is this how she controls her people? By engaging their primitive superstitions? I saw absolute reverence in their eyes when they spoke of her. Yet, I also sense fear. Her people are treated with fairness, taxed reasonably, and are well protected by her stone god. No wonder some of them even pray to her. It's as if she were more than just a queen to them. Spreading discontent through her people may well be a harder task than I imagined.